new generation tanks of the future. Tanks of the future will be unmanned robotic systems. The creation of unmanned mobile combat and support robotic systems is now one of the key and very promising areas for the development of weapons of warfare. Currently, relevant developments are underway in the field of robotization of armored weapons as part of a comprehensive target program. This is made possible to create a number of experimental and operational prototypes of robotic systems and military complexes. Now, the improvement of armored weapons and equipment is planned to be carried out by searching for new unconventional layout solutions, automating the processes of fire control, protection, movement, increasing survivability and autonomy, improving ergonomics, and introducing artificial intelligence elements into the design. At the same time, primarily the modernization of the existing fleet of T-72 and T-80 tanks is envisaged. In addition, a promising new generation Russian tank and vehicles based on it are being developed. Its firepower and protection will significantly exceed the capabilities of the existing T-90 tank. Currently, the leading manufacturers in Germany, the USA, and France are not only creating a mobile BTT and working on the appearance of the machine of the future, but also continue to modernize the existing fleet of Leopard, Abrams, and Leclerc tanks. So, for example, simultaneously with the creation of new light vehicles in the United States, the M1 Abrams tanks are being modernized to the level of the M1A2 SEP tank by equipping them with digital electronic equipment, a system for exchanging information with other machines, a digital automated workstation for a driver, and onboard navigation equipment. The Leopard 2 combat vehicle has recently undergone a modernization process at the production of base of the German company Krauss Maffei Wegmann. The new tank model was named L2A7+. So, the following details appeared on the new tank: modular armor, high precision weapons, indicators and characteristics in the surveillance system were much improved, and there were also more external cameras. After the presentation of this tank, the German Ministry of Defense announced that 150 Leopard 2A6 tanks would undergo a similar upgrade. To date, Germany's armament is represented by 225 Leopard 2A6 and 125 2A5 tanks. We should also mention the modular armor of this tank, which appeared after the modernization. Such armor makes it possible to save the life of the entire crew in the event of a tank hitting a mine or any other improvised explosive device. The modernization process also added an extra layer of protection to the Leopard. This layer is designed to protect the tank from RPGs. Now, even an auto instructor will be able to drive such a car. And then there is the dual kit armor complex, which protects the tank in frontal projection from kinetic and cumulative ammunition. Most likely, not all the gadgets of the tank were published. In any case, the Germans created an excellent combat vehicle. British gunsmiths presented conceptual designs aimed at reducing the visibility of armored vehicles. end of this month, testing of a visual camouflage system should begin, which will turn the tank into a kind of chameleon. On both sides of the vehicle, beams of 9 video cameras will be placed, which will record the surrounding landscape and transmit the image to the displays built into the armor. The latter, using beams of organic light-emitting diodes, OLED, should project an image onto a layer of screens covered with transparent composite armor, in front and on the sides of the tank. To make it clearer, projection TVs work on the same principle. Alas, it will not be possible to completely hide the car. The developers still have not figured out how to cover the tracks and the turret. Nevertheless, it will certainly become less noticeable, especially if it hides in ambush and does not defiantly roll across the field. A working version of such technology is planned to be obtained in the next 5 years. Another important condition for invisibility is the reduction of the thermal radiation of the tank, which, as you know, some anti-tank missiles are aimed at. British engineers have an answer for this too. They propose a system for collecting fluid from the engine exhaust and then transferring it to the outer surfaces of armored vehicles. Evaporating water by analogy with human sweat will cool.